Good morning students, I am Dr. Tripti Gupta from Shivjyoti Education Group Kota. So welcome to the English class. Today we are going to start with the chapter number 7 of First Flight book, that is Glimpse of India, part 2. That the part 2 is Coorg, which is written by Lokesh Ebral. So now let us look some information about the author first, Lokesh Ebral. So the author of Coorg is Lokesh Ebral. Now let us see, he was born on 20th February 1961 in Gurgaon, Haryana, and he did his schooling from Lady Fatima Convent School, Gurgaon. As the student of Senior Model School, Hisar, he topped in his Matric exam in Haryana in 1976. Now after that he completed his MBBS MD from Maharshi Dayanand University from 1978 till 1987. Lokesh Ebral's ultimate goal is to promote nature and heritage conservation by spreading knowledge, awareness, pride and love for all that is beautiful in this world. So here he has written the chapter Coorg, which is the part of chapter number 7, The Glimpse of India. Okay. So now let us move ahead with our chapter Coorg. So Coorg, as we can say, is a coffee tree. Coffee country, famous for its rainforests and spices. Now it is a beautiful place, seems like a piece of heaven, and has drifted away from God's kingdom and has settled on earth. This is how the author Lokesh, he has described this place Coorg here. And now this place is somewhere between Mysore and Mangalore in Karnataka. Okay. It is an area with low hills of unequal heights, and the men here are very brave warriors. Okay. They are known for their valor. Okay. The women of Coorg, they are very pretty. The place has a variety of wild animals too, because there is dense evergreen rainforest in this area. Now also known as Coorg, this place Coorg is also known as Coorg, and this is the smallest district of Karnataka, and the evergreen forests are basically been there. Somewhere around 30% of this district is covered by evergreen forests, and the place, it receives rain for all most of the part of the year. Okay. For complete year, over the year, most of the time it has been raining. Okay. Especially during the monsoon season, it receives very good rain. The period from September till March, it is the most loved season by the visitors, by the tourists in this place. The weather is pleasant and there is some rain which makes it worthwhile to visit that place during this season. Okay, the air has been filled with strong fragrance of coffee due to the abundant coffee plantation, which Coorg is been known. Okay, so the coffee plantation is a very significant aspect which we can see here in Coorg. Now as we can see here in the next paragraph, the people of Coorg are being described they are believed to be Greek or Arabic background people, and they are very ferocious. Okay, they have been very frightless people. They are very brave. This theory came into being because of their dressing style, because they are generally seen wearing a long black coat with embroidered waist belt, okay, which they put on their waist, and which is known as kufia. This kufia is very similar to kufia worn by Arabs or Kurds. Okay, so it is also rumored that some people from Alexander's army, they could not return back, and they settled down here while they are returning from the South India. The people of Kur, they marry each other, and their culture as well as rituals are very different from Hindu rituals, traditions. Okay, so this place, the people, they are very hospitable. That means, this is a word been used here, that is hospitable. That means they are very welcoming. They welcome people with lots of immense love for visitors and strangers. Okay, so their hospitality is being famous, and they are more than willing to recount numerous tale of valor related to their sons and fathers. So they keep on narrating the various incidents of bravery which are been there in their history, and they keep on narrating all those things to the visitors. Now, as we can see, the Kurg regiment is this independent, ferocious and brave feature, or this character of this place, of the people of Kurg, is been very evident in the, as we can see, in Kurg regiment of Indian Army. It has received the maximum number of awards for bravery. The first chief of Indian Army named General Kariappa, he also belonged to Kurg place. Okay, he was also a Kurgi. Also, these are only people who are permitted to keep, to carry firearms like guns. Okay, those are firearms. They do not need a license for carrying those firearms. They are being allowed to carry the guns along with them. This shows that Kurgs are very reliable people. Okay, by character, by as the feature of their personality, they are very reliable, very brave people. Okay, and they are trustworthy people. That's why they are being allowed to carry firearms even without license. Okay, now here, as we can move further here, the adventures, which are very important aspect of Kurg, that is being described here by the author, that is the evergreen forests and the hills of Kurg, they provide water to River Kaveri, that is the major river in South India. A large freshwater fish, mahaseer, is found in these waters. Okay, and lot of rippling effect one can find on the waves of the surface of the water, especially which is caused because of light breeze. Very breeze means very slow flowing air. Okay, and whenever the objects are being dropped by the macaques or langurs in the water, that rippling effect gives the beauty of that water, surface of the water gets rippled. Okay, now another aspect which is being shown here, which is beautifully described by the author, is the bathing elephants which are being scrubbed by mahouts. Okay, so the mahouts, these are huge beasts like elephants which are being here, which they enjoy their they are bathed and they are being scrubbed by mahouts, and they enjoy taking bath in river water. Now, so this is how the kingfishers are being diving. They are fishing the fish from the fresh water. Okay, so these are beautiful scenic beauty which you can find in the wildlife of Coorg. Now, another very attractive aspect of Coorg is that the tourists who visit Coorg, they get relaxed because of the natural beauty of this place, and they also get attracted towards the various adventure sports activities which can be taken up, like river rafting, canoeing, rappelling, rock climbing, mountain climbing. All these adventurous activities are very prominently being taken up by the tourists who used to visit this area, because they enjoy taking up these adventure activities. Now, the hills have various paths formed by the footsteps of the walkers who track there. So the mountain tracking is very commonly been a sport which is being taken up by tourists, and you can find those footsteps, those tracks on mountains which are being created because of mountain tracking. So that is another beautiful aspect here. Now, while taking a walk in this region, one can easily find a variety of animals around them. Okay, birds, bees, butterflies. See here, there is a picture of Coorg people. Okay, see here, the birds, bees, butterflies, and there to give you company, they all are being there when you take a walk, a long walk in this beautiful place. Macaques, Malabar squirrels, langurs, and cylinder lorries, they keep a watchful eye from the tree canopy. See, what happens here is, watchful eye means these all wildlife are being the part of that forest area, and you can find them looking at you while you are walking through on the roads, on the path, and you can find them that they have been watching you curiously while you have been, and you can also enjoy them in their natural habitat in this area. Okay, so this is how the wildlife has immense beauty in this place. Now, to have an overall look at the beauty of Coorg, one must climb up the Brahmagiri hills. Those are the prominent destination which can give you an overall very scenic beauty of Coorg. The Coorg has been surrounded by astounding places of beauty, and like islands of Nisargadham and Bailakuppu. Bailakuppu is the India's largest Tibetan settlement. Okay, where you can find number of monks, they are being, see, it's the highest Tibetan settlement. That means there are huge number of monks. You can find them wearing yellow and orange and red color, ochre colored garments. Okay, so you can find them very distinctly. You can distinguish them that these are the Tibetan monks. You can find them in Coorg, and you can watch them, you can view their lifestyle, and that view of Tibetan settlement is fascinating, is beautiful to look over there. a mix of a diverse culture can be seen here in Coorg, which represents the heart and soul of India. So this is how the author Lokesh Abrol has beautifully picturized, described and given you a very immense beauty of Coorg in this chapter. So students, I hope I have made my concepts clear to you and hope you must enjoy reading this beautiful description of. So students, prepare the chapter well. Thank you very much.